Hello everybody, my name is Biswarup. I do teach in the Department of Electrical Engineering, IIT Roorkee. In this course on computer-aided power system analysis, we are essentially going to cover five different topics. These topics are load flow analysis of AC transmission grid. Second is load flow analysis of AC-DC grid, that is the load flow analysis of an AC transmission grid in which there would be one or more LCC based HVDC link. Third, we would be covering the aspect of contingency analysis. Fourth topic we would be covering is the state estimation of power system. And the fifth one would be covering the fault analysis of the power system. In this course, we would be basically talking about the transmission grid. We will not at all touch about the distribution grid. Now, to give a just very brief introduction to each of this topic, we would be first covering all the aspects of the AC load flow analysis, by which we do calculate the operating point of any power grid given the generation as well as the load profile. Secondly, in the module of this AC-DC load flow, you would be again calculating the operating point of a power grid in which there is one or more HVDC link. In this case also, you would be calculating the operating points given the generation profile as well as the load profile. In the third module, that is on the contingency analysis, so you would be analyzing the operation of the power system in case there is an outage of any particular element. Say, for example, if there is an outage of a generator or if there is an outage of a transmission line, we would try to estimate that what would happen to the remaining elements of the system. In the fourth one, that is on the state estimation of power system, we would be looking into the aspect to actually monitor the power system on a real-time basis. So, in this case, we would be assuming that there are several measurements available in the system, and then we will try to estimate the voltages as well as the angles at each and every bus of the system based on those available measurements, and followed by and also looking into the aspect that how to detect the presence of any gross erroneous measurement, which we call in turn a bad data. So in this case, we will also try to find out that whether there is any kind of bad data or not. And in the fifth one, we would be again looking into the aspect of a fault analysis of the power system. In contrast to the fault analysis of the power system, which you have studied in our undergraduate course, in this course, we will be looking into the fault analysis of a power system in the phase ABC domain. Because in the symmetrical component-based approach, you have to find out three different networks for any given system, which is quite clumsy. So, to eliminate that problem in this course, we will be looking into the procedure of calculating the fault currents in the phase ABC domain. So, hopefully that you will all enjoy this course. Thank you.